And now it's time for the mix. Oh, what a sad milestone this Saturday morning.
Oh, it was
very
awful.
Sad milestone. It was the first Saturday morning in 50 years that there were no cartoons. Can you believe it? This was an old FCC ruling that they had to have, every channel had to have a certain amount of educational programming. So many of the networks decided to do it on Saturday morning since it wouldn't cut into prime time. The last channel to sort of hold out was the CW network, and they've dropped that. So no more. I mean, it was a tradition for me. Fruit Loops or Cocoa Puffs and the Get Along Gang was what I always started it off with.
No more Saturday morning cartoons.
Yeah.
That is really sad. Let's go to some upbeat pictures now out of New Mexico. These are nice pictures. We do this, see this every year. This is the 43rd year of it this time around. But the Balloon Fest, the Hot Air Balloon Fiesta, as they call it out there. But look at that. It's always cool to see them take off in the morning. But they launched, you got 550 pilots out there. But new this year, they all have tablets that can run this app that shows them, bless you.
Sorry,
everything okay over there?
I'm just getting excited about all the hot air coming out.
That's not just me. She's not talking about me, folks. I'm not the hot air. But look at the pictures here. But it was cool. It's a 9-day festival. It'll be going out there for another week at least.
I love it when they do these human pyramids with the cheerleading team. But in Spain, they may have one-upped even the cheerleading squad. Take a look at this. This is a human tower. And
there we go.
Isn't it beautiful? They
wow.
Tarragona, Spain. They dress up in these color-coded teams, and they do these incredible human towers. They were actually declared by UNESCO as one of the humanity's masterpieces of the oral and intangible heritage of humanity.
Oh, I'm sorry. What was that again?
I'm not going to repeat that, but it's just amazing. And it's all done by people. Towers done by people.
Okay, that is cool. That's a little more than the college, you know, cheerleading squad.
Totally.
One last thing to end on here. The Olympics. We all like to watch the Olympics, whether it's the Summer Games, whether it's the Winter Games. Would you watch the nude games? The nude Olympics taking place out there. Oh, good job by our team there covering this stuff up. This is out in San Francisco. This is the second time they've done this. But their events, yes, they do foot races, javelin throwing, beach volleyball. They even do tug of war. Now, some people just like to be naked.
This is non-sexual?
This is non-sexual, we're told. Right?
Okay.
Nothing sexual about running around naked.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, the city has some rules and restrictions in place about nudity. But the guy who organized the games, he actually filed a lawsuit saying, hey, we should be able to run around naked if we want to. But the second time they've done this out there. So a lot of people show up just because they're curious.
Would you compete?
No, I don't think I would. It's cold out in San Francisco.
It is, this time
By
of year especially.
Yeah, we don't want to do that.
Coming up, more news from ABC.